Hi, I'm Ryan Butler, and I thought as the first video on my channel, I'd compare two Linux distros from around the same time period that took very different approaches to consumer-based Linux. The first one I'm going to try is Xandros 3, and I've already got this installed. In a later video, I might throw the installation, but I'll have to cut that around, you know, cut some parts, because it can be quite long. So let's start this up while I talk. So what I find is that this is a more commercial distro. There was no free version of this, at least not initially. And if there was one, it came out much later. There was, you know, no sources for most of the configuration tools. They heavily customized KDE, which is the desktop environment Linux uses in both of these. And whereas Mandrake uses a slightly customized version, Xandros, it's barely recognizable. They modified it a lot. And as you can see, this boot screen, pretty simple. I do like that it has the text indicating a couple of key problem areas. So here we are at the login screen. Again, very simple. There isn't even a way to change the desktop environment. But Xandros is basically locked down into KDE. So I'm going to log in here. And you'll see the login screen that looks fairly good. And here is Xandros Desktop 3.0. So if you look at it, it looks fairly good. Obviously, this is a Windows-style start menu, but not too Windows-style. I do like the Windows-style start menu on the left here. That's pretty cool. So one thing Xandros did is they bundled Crossover Office. And here it is. Crossover Office lets you run Office and some other programs, but the main program they were focusing on is, as you can see, Microsoft Office 2000, XP, or 97, and some other programs that would be considered part of Office, like Project or PowerPoint or Visio or Word or Excel Viewer. There's some other stuff. Windows Media Player is a good program here, so we're not going to throw too much of that right now. I might make another video on that later. So here is the rest of Xandros. It does come with Acrobat Reader. This is the real version, not like a lot of Linux distros which come with, you know, a clone PDF viewer. This is Acrobat Reader, version 5 for Linux. And it works. It looks kind of ugly because it's, I think it's using Modif, maybe? I don't know what it's using. It's ugly. But it does the job. Unfortunately, I don't have any PDFs, I don't think. Comes with web browser, which is Mozilla, and they didn't actually bother to rename it, like, in terms of the, you know, the about screen. It just says it's Mozilla, and that's what it is. I don't know if I have internet set up here. Looks like at this time I do not. I might fix that. Yeah, internet not working. But anyway, that's Mozilla. It wouldn't do too much anyway. There's some other stuff. There's all these little programs. These are fairly similar in both because they're KDE programs. You've got calculator. You've got, you know, a print thing. Which I don't think this lets you make printers. It just lets you control the ones you already have. And we don't have any, so it's not very useful. And so forth. You have a text editor, which is, they include the basic one. I don't think Xandros even includes Kate, which is the advanced text editor, the development style one. And you got some more viewers. You got some basic games. I think they heavily focused on a Microsoft style selection. You know, Mahjong, Reversi, Solitaire, and Minesweeper. Which, here's Minesweeper. It's K-Mines. It looks pretty similar to K-Mines today, actually. And if you look at the other stuff, they've got a digital camera program, but I don't have any, I guess I could set up a directory, I guess. Let me do that. I wonder why this isn't done automatically if there's already a Pixies directory. That kind of sucks. But if you look at DigiCam, it opens in a really stupid window, like really tiny. And, you know, it looks fairly basic, but it looks like they're already doing a lot with this program, even early on. It looks nice. How much? Version 7.0, version 0.7 SCVS fairly early on in that program's life cycle. And I imagine that would be one major problem with Xandros, is that the image tools provided with it are not very good, and you have to use Xandros networks, which costs money, I believe, to get better ones. So the other stuff it comes with KDE mail, Mozilla, including that mail, connects into the internet tool, connecting to the VPN tool, connection wizard. If you look at some of these tools, you need to use connection wizard before you can connect to the internet. Okay, so I want to use LAN. Let's see if this works. All users, detecting hardware. Yep, that's it. We'll call it LAN. Don't need a host name. Dynamic. Okay, connect to the internet. Let's give myself a host name of Xandros3. I've never seen LAN connections done like this. This is super strange. But I suppose it might work. Let's see. Let's view the log, see what we're getting here. Okay, we're up. So this looks pretty good. Let's load up the Mozilla. You see if they have a quick launch thing here, which obviously very reminiscent of Windows. Okay, the internet still doesn't work. I think it's a DNS problem. I'm not too worried about it. Let me see if my local network works at least. Oh no, wait, never mind. The internet works. It took a while. So if you look, they do. It's very similar to Windows, but there's a couple differences that Xandros didn't paper over. Like renaming this icon, I don't even know how you do it. And if you want to delete it or move it, it's not quite as simple as it is in Windows. Like if you just go, that doesn't move it, it doesn't work. You'd have to go move and then drag, and that's kind of cumbersome in my opinion. And here's the help. So Xandros includes their own help, which is based on KDE help, but has some of their own stuff. And the other thing Xandros customized extensively is the file manager. There's actually one more thing they customized, but that'll be a bit later. The file manager has a Windows network support built in. And it's very simple to use if it works, and it might not because I haven't logged out since I connected to the internet. So it might not work. But yeah, here we go. Here are some of my files. Here's HP DC1500. It's one of my computers. We'll see if it can connect to it. Let's enter my password here. Give it time. You notice these cursors are very reminiscent of Windows as well. They're very obviously copying Windows. They even have a throbber here. I don't know why I even want one of those. The layout of the menu bar is also very similar to Windows and the toolbars. So, yeah, it did manage to get into, and look, it's even using backslashes in the SMB, just like Windows. So it did manage to get into my network, it looks like. And it lets you mount it to an actual mount point, which is pretty cool. And it looks like just like Windows when it does that, too. It's a pretty good design, I'd say, especially if you're new to Linux. If you go here, you have your home directory. They put a My Documents directory in, like other Linux, which has just a Documents directory. The rest of it, you've got basically the same options as a KDE file manager. For some reason, it crashed when I chose Faux Hidden Files. Hopefully, I can get it to come back. Let me just try killing it. Okay. So, ignoring the hidden files because they don't work. There's other things. There's a printer adding wizard. And as you can see, they've made it very similar to Windows for the printer adding wizard. Let's try to add a network printer. Network type Windows. We'll go to HP DC5800. Do I even have a printer? Anyway, I guess we don't really need to see the printer adding wizard. Let me just cancel out of this if I can. But you get the picture. It's a printer adding wizard. The rest of it, fairly similar to Windows. There are toolbars that, you know, you can drag around just like Windows. There's a Find button, which, again, this looks pretty similar to Windows 98's Find. If you search for things like, by default, it doesn't do a case-sensitive search, which is good for Windows users who don't want a case-sensitive search. If you search for, like, documents, it's not case-sensitive. For some reason, though, it didn't find the My Documents directory. So let me see if that... I don't know. Maybe it doesn't find folders, just files. Let me close that. And it has, as you can see, DVD writing support. It has the ability to create CDs. And it lets you insert and mount discs and create symbolic links very easily. It's a pretty good program. So the other convenient thing that Xandros included, they included a lot of things like this process manager, which is, I believe, just a KDE version, yeah. Just generic KDE process manager. But the convenient thing they included is administrative tools. Specifically, they included, where is it? An extensively customized version of the KDE Control Center, which, as you can see, this is KDE version 3.3 on Xandros 3. And if you look at the settings, a lot of them are very similar to Xandros. I don't think this taskbar thing is the same as KDE. This is, I believe, customized. And it lets you do things like grouping similar tasks, like in XP. The fonts, a lot of this stuff is fairly similar to standard KDE. But if you look down, there's some stuff that isn't. Hardware information, I believe, is also in standard KDE, or most of it. Network, I don't think that is. And this lets you hit this administrative button to enter your password, which I will try to tell it to keep, because I don't want to keep doing this. And it will let you manage your network connections right here within the same control panel you use for everything else, just like in Windows. And as you can see, you can play with DNS, you can do stuff like that. Let's not do any of that right now. So that's nice. That is very useful. A lot of these, everything here looks fairly similar to Windows, and I suppose that would be helpful. The Windows networking settings lets you do, like, the work group, the SWINs, security fairs, nice stuff. If you look at the joystick, they have a joystick setup. They have keyboard. They have mouse. They have power management, which includes laptop battery, power control. Sound and multimedia has sound system control. And system administration is where they have some more Xandros custom stuff, like boot manager, which lets you choose your default operating system, although on this system there's only Xandros. Change password, which lets you change your password. And also change how passwords work. The login manager, which doesn't do much because you can only log in as one type of user. I mean, one type of desktop. It does let you select users who can log in and a couple of other things. Lets you do auto login or password list login, other insecure things. Remote desktop sharing works like in XP. You can disable background images, assign ports. Services works, you know, you can disable SSHs, just like, they're called services, whereas really in Linux they are daemons, but I suppose that's for Windows user convenience. And look, the start mode, this looks just like in XP, as well as automatic manual. The user manager, which works pretty much like you would expect, and even has a little wizard, which I suppose is designed to make Windows users who like wizards feel at home. So let's... the standard set of access. Okay, that's probably fine. Let's not encrypt our home folder. And there you go. That's the user manager. So those are the customizations they've made. They've made a couple others. Let's look at this quick start guide and see if it's anything interesting. As you can see, they do include virtual desktops. They don't hide those, like some Linux distros designed for Windows do. They have made a couple of other changes. Let's see if there's any... Okay, multimedia. This is a good point. They included a bunch of multimedia applications. You've got this MP3 player here, What's my sound? I'm not sure if it's working right now, but you get the picture. It's a multimedia player. It's XMMS. It's fairly well known as a Winamp clone. Used to be popular in the Linux world, and it plays MP3s. There are codecs included to play MP3s if you need to. They have a MIDI player. They have this confusingly named Media Player, which looks like Windows Media Player with this logo here. And what it actually is the KDE Media Player, which isn't even named in Xandros. They customized that. But that's what it is. And if you look, they've also customized the KDE directory structure. Confusingly. Sounds... That's KDE, and if you look at some of the other stuff, they have a sound recorder, which is cool. They have a CD player, audio builder, which is, I don't even know what this is, arts builder. Never heard of this program. Let's get rid of it. And they have OpenOffice, of course. Some of these versions of Xandros came with StarOffice 7, and I actually have that, and I might install it on this system at some point later on. They have a remote desktop sharing thing. They have an event viewer, just like Windows, which is very similar. And they have this first run wizard, which is not my first run, but I'm going to go through it real quick just to show you. Right hand, yep. This clock. Notice it doesn't say anything about UTC time. You got the printer set up, which looks just like how Windows would ask you when you first started. First installed Windows, you know, what printer are you using? And it lets you change what your theme is and stuff to make it look like KDE or Windows or Xandros. I am not going to change anything. I'm going to leave it alone. But overall, it's a fairly polished desktop, but it's definitely very eccentric. It's not very Linuxy. It's very, very Windowsy. And a lot of heavy modifications were made to KDE, very obviously, to make this work. It's unfortunate, in my opinion, because it makes it hard to use anything else. It makes KDE look funky. But it's a pretty good desktop, and I could see a basic usage being pretty good. So let's log out of Xandros. Shut down. Quit this. Notice that shut down looks like XP as well. And then we get into this, which is designed to cover up the command line boot process and shutdown process. And here we go. Shutdown is complete. So let me load up Mandrake Linux. This is version 9.2. I installed a few programs on it. We're going to start it up. As you can see, it uses this graphical boot menu. And then it goes into a graphics-based boot progress meter, which is going to start now. You can press escape to get more information, but we don't need any more information, and the system boots very quickly because I'm using an SSD here. So let's just enter. We're entering into KDE. Mandrake does support other desktops, but I don't want to use any of them, so we're going to use KDE. And here you go, here's Mandrake. As you can see, this is using the standard Conqueror file browser. I have a bunch of files that I added to this without any customizations. Conqueror 3.1, it's using a little bit older version of KDE. So one disadvantage of the standard Conqueror file manager is the networking support for SMB is not as good. However, it definitely looks more like Linux in the file tree. There's I think it's possible to get a tree over on the left. No, that's different mode. Maybe a multi-column mode. Not sure what you do to... I don't know how that works. But maybe this is a separate view for it or something. But it's a very different experience using this compared to using Xandros in terms of the file manager. The find files experience is pretty similar, and it's pretty obvious they're using similar designs. You also notice Mandrake has applied the Galaxy theme. And the galaxy theme, in my opinion, looks very good. So, there's some other modifications they have made in Mandrake. The desktop wallpaper used to be different, I believe. I think I changed it. Let me see if Mandrake has, like, a desktop wallpaper that they would have applied. Let's go to wallpaper. Mandrake backgrounds default. Yeah, here's the Mandrake wallpaper that would have been applied by default. At least for the download, it isn't. So they've got this as the font, and actually, the fonts look a little different on this version. They have subpixel hinting as an option. I don't know how well that'll work. Let me close and restart this program and see if I notice any difference. It looks okay. So Mandrake's design is that they have a classic panel, and overall, it's a little different in the panel layout from Xandros. It's more like a KDE standard panel. Like, the KDE logo is here instead of, you know, a Xandros logo. These icons are presented more like in panel format. There's four desktops by default instead of two. Nothing majorly different, but a little different here and there. If we go down, you can see that in System, there aren't as many entries as in Xandros, because Xandros added a lot of entries to System. And if you look around elsewhere, you can see that there aren't as many entries in networking, for instance. There's a configuration for the Xandros, for the Samba client. I don't think Xandros even had this, because Xandros had a different Samba client. It doesn't install the SMB servers by default, I believe Xandros did. Desktop sharing. God damn it, let me see that. And yeah, that's fairly similar to the Xandros. If you go in here, you can see that there is no, like, Xandros on the left to make it look more like Windows. And the applications are grouped, I believe, slightly differently. I don't know if all these were included with it, but Kate, I believe, was included with Mandrake by default. And Kate is much more advanced than Kwrite, which is also included by default. And most of the rest of the applications are similar. And, you know, you can get a pretty similar set of applications on either platform. There is the GIMP included on Mandrake. So let's load that up real quick. It's an old version of the GIMP. I don't really know how to use it, so we'll quit it. This included OpenOffice. Actually, I don't think it included OpenOffice because it predated it. But I have installed OpenOffice 1.1 from a RPM. Since, unlike Xandros, which is Debian-based, this is Red Hat-based. So I used a OpenOffice RPM. And it looks fairly good, in my opinion. I would definitely think this would be a good, you know, platform for office management. And in terms of networking software, there's an AIM client, IRC clients, a lot of these are probably recognizable today. Mail client, Mozilla Mail is not included by default. They didn't include Mozilla at all in the default install. I did install it. I can't remember where it went. Ah, here it is. And, you know, a lot of the rest of the stuff, Mandrake includes some interesting stuff that isn't in Xandros, like the mTools file manager, which is for DOS systems, and GNUcas, which is a financial management software here. Create a new set of accounts. Well, it's not. But overall, and notice how Mandrake has also themed KDK to look sort of like Qt in this version. But overall, they're not too different. One big difference is if you look at the configure your computer setup here and enter my password here, Mandrake, that's not the right password. Mandrake has a separate configuration utility for administrative, unlike Linux, unlike Windows or unlike Xandros. In Mandrake, for configuring administrative stuff, it's an entirely separate window. And here it is. You can produce an auto-install floppy. You can change how your system boots. You can launch graphically. Unlike Xandros, you can turn that off. You can change the default desktop, which, unlike Xandros, you can do that. Yeah, let's go to this. Unlike Xandros, it's a full-featured disk partitioner here, which, as you can see, I've got this set up. You can set mount points here, and this is one of the main ways you mount file systems, you mount network file systems in Mandrake, and I don't know how well it'll work. Unfortunately, on this, I'm using NAT, so it won't work with my network setup, but I don't know how well it would work in real life. And as you can see, it lets you export using SMB or NFS using this wizard thing. I don't want to install from a CD, which I'll need to, so I'm not going to tell you how this works, but it's certainly functional. The network connection setup is kind of confusing, in my opinion. I think Xandros did this better. Let's close this. The security level setup is, there we go, kind of useful. It lets you set port securities and some other things, like whether you can log in as root from externally and X11, how open X11 is. Very useful to have, you know, authorized TCP configurations to X window. This is a pretty useful feature. A lot of this stuff is available in command line options, but nice to have a GUI for it. Firewall, useful to have. I've turned it off, but you can turn it on and set up which ports to allow through. Permission level stuff, I don't even know what the point of this is, but it's nice. Menu Drake, system menu. Useful to have. The integrated Mandrake menu works across all the desktops, both KDE and GNOME, which is very nice. Obviously, Xandros doesn't even have to worry about that. The Display Manager queue there lets you go between KDM, XDM, and I believe GDM if you have GNOME Display Manager installed, which I do not. The Services and Daemons lets you change your services and daemons, just like in Xandros, but in my opinion, this version looks rather more cumbersome than Xandros' tool. The Log Server is like the Event Viewer, but I'm not sure how to use it. It seems a little more complicated. The font installer tool lets you preview your fonts and also install fonts. You can install Windows fonts. You can add fonts. Kind of confusing how there's multiple different ways to add fonts. But I suppose fonts in Linux were not very good at the time. The time and date setter is another way to set the date and time. KDE also has one of these. The user Drake utility, user Drake here, is a user adding and removing tool, which works much like the Xandros one. But it does not use wizards. It does let you set icons for your user. So let's set up a user here real quick, and then we'll delete it. Yep, we'll delete the home directory, and we'll exit the tool. Very simple, easy to work with, very fast too, because there's no wizards. The RPM Drake lets you manage packages, but that's going to ask me to insert the CD, so I'm not going to do it. But it is a very good tool. It does configure dependencies automatically for most things, although it can have problems with that periodically, but it's very good for a distro of the time. And it's GUI-based, fairly nice and easy to use. I like it. And that was a quick tour of Mandrake. I have some software installed in this I might show you at a later date. Let me just show you the documentation, if it's available. Obviously, I won't show you all of it, but as you can see, they did include a conveniently long set of documentation. All of this stuff does go somewhere. You can look at it all. So they have a nice set of documentation here for the beginning Mandrake Linux user. So back in the day, if you weren't sure how to use Linux, this would probably help you out. So that is Mandrake Linux. And, you know, it's very obviously a more community-driven project than Xandros Linux. And it's, I think I like it. I like it a lot. But some people might not like it. It's definitely a little rougher around the edges, I feel. But pretty good. Notice I have the Windows programs installed via crossover. Here we got Office and stuff. Let's log out and let's turn off the computer. Notice the stock KDE turning off dialog here, as opposed to the different one that Xandros uses. And it uses graphical shutdown screen here, which is nice. We'll let it do that, and that's the end of this video.